students, today we are going to learn how to separate the substances from the mixture in the lesson separation of substances. See children, what is a mixture, what is a substance, we'll see now. See, in our daily life we use so many different type of items. Your mother is going to follow different separation techniques for separating the mixtures. See, what do you understand by the word mixture? Yes, right children? When you hear the word mixture, you feel it is anything to eat. Yes, right? It is correct. See, mixture is anything, the eatables which contains groundnut or grams, different types of grams, and you find different types of cornflakes also in it. Yes, it is a mixture of so many different type of items in it. But here, in our daily life, we use different type of substances. For example, rice, dals, if they are mixed together. Flour, if they are combined by mistake, mixed together, then we need to separate them before cooking. Yes, right children? See here, substance in any material or thing which is pure in state, it is called as a substance. If at all it is mixed with some other different substances, it is called as a mixture. See, I'll show you one example. So here in this jar, you can see different types of grams, they are mixed together. Then if at all they are containing only one substance like this, like groundnut, then it is called as a single substance like groundnut. But all the different grams, they are mixed together, then it is called as a mixture of grams. So this is called as a mixture. And if at all you can see here in this rice, it is a single substance. So like this, if it is only one substance, then it is called a substance. If it is a combination of substances, then it is called as a mixture. So before using, we need to separate them. So there are different types of separating techniques or separating methods. So what are the different methods of separation? First one is hand picking, winnowing, sieving and filtration, sedimentation and decantation, crystallization, distillation, sublimation, chromatography. So these are the different methods of separation techniques. So we'll perform the activities and I'll show you how to separate substances from the mixtures. Right children, come. So here this is a mixture where so many different grams have been mixed up. So which of the technique we are going to use here is by hand picking. So this mixture can be separated like this. By the hand, depending upon the size and shape, we need to separate them like this. This process is called as hand picking. So here, if any substance like heavier material and lighter substances are present together, we need to use a winnower. See here children, this is a winnower. The farmer uses mainly like this, and your mother also uses, if at all before cooking the rice, she uses the winnower to separate the any dust particles present in the rice. Due to the air flow, the dust particles will be removed from the rice. So this is a sieve which we are using of different sizes. This is a strainer which is used for removing the tea leaves before filtering the tea. Yes, depending upon the size of the material need to be separated, different size of sieves will be used. This is of different size of the sieve where before making the dough, the flour need to be sieved so that any dirt particles like husk present in the flour will be
separated like this. Now we'll see the filtration technique, where this is the funnel, glass funnel, and in it a filter paper of different size, that is this, there are small pores in the filter paper. Through it any dust particles will be removed. See, for example, the mud water, when it is mixed with the mud water, it can be filtered through this filter paper like this, so that the particles will be separated from the water. You can see the clear water or the filtrate, you can see the dirty particles will remain on the filter paper. So this is a filtration technique. Now we'll see the process of sedimentation and decantation. See children, what is sedimentation? See, if at all water is mixed with the mud like this, so keep it aside for some time to settle down. See, after some time, see, after keeping undisturbed the water, the muddy water, for some time, the mud is going to settle at the bottom like this. This is called as sediment. So this process of settling of the mud to the bottom of the glass is called sedimentation. So now, without disturbing the water, we need to pour into another glass like this with an inclined angle, so that the upper water is moved into another glass. So this process is called as decantation. So firstly we have done sedimentation, so that the mud has settled at the bottom of the glass as a sediment. Now we are removing the water from the upper side of the glass, so that we have transferred the water into the other glass. This is called decantation. Now you can see the sediment has left over in another glass. This is sedimentation and decantation. Now we are going to see the process of crystallization, where we have taken the salt water in a beaker and kept on a flame, so that the water in the beaker gets heated up and evaporated, leaving the salts as a crystals. So after heating, the water in the beaker gets evaporated and the salt will form as a crystal. See, in the this is a technique for formation of the salt. Near the seas, it will be, the water is going to kept in the larger pans, so that it gets evaporated. The water gets evaporated and we will get the salt. So now we are going to see the process of distillation, where so many impurities will be present in the water. When it is heated, the water gets boiled and it changes, the water in the liquid form changes into vapor form, and it will be collected, the vapors will be collected and it gets condensed through the pipe and it will be collected in the other glass jar, so that this water is the purified or the distilled water. All the impurities which are present in the water will be removed by this process of distillation. This is the process of sublimation, where I have taken the camphor powder on a glass. So this camphor, it is in the solid form. See, when it is heated, it directly converts into vapor form without conversion into liquid form. See, I am putting a funnel which is closed on the other end of the funnel, so that the fumes will be collected in the funnel like this. See children, this is the process of sublimation, where the solid camphor is converting into vapor form without converting into liquid form. Now we'll see the process of chromatography. Here a substance, it is made up of a single color or it is a mixture of colors, we will check by the process of chromatography. So for it, I have taken a chalk piece. See, onto it I'll draw a line on the chalk piece with a black marker like this, so that we will check whether the black is a single color or whether it is a mixture of colors. See children, I am putting this chalk in the water. See, we will keep like this in the water untouched and leave it for some time and check what is happening. See, you can see the different colors have been separated by the process of chromatography. By the capillary action from the water, you can see the black color is not a single color, it is a mixture of colors. You can see the pink, blue and yellowish color which are getting separated along the chalk piece. So this process of separation of colored substances is called as chromatography. See children, here along with the sand particles and mud particles, you can also find the iron substances are also present. So we cannot separate by hand picking, sieving or any other technique. So how can we separate the iron substances from the mixture of sand and mud? Here is a technique called magnetic separation. So we need to bring a magnet. So in the earlier classes we have studied that magnetic substance are attracted towards the magnet. So here if you want to separate this iron substances from the sand particles, we need to bring the magnet near the sand particles. So all the iron substances, they will be attracted towards the magnet. See children, how they are coming and attracting towards the magnet. You can see the iron fillings present in the sand, they are coming and attracting towards the magnet. So this process is called magnetic separation.
So children, we have seen different separation techniques and perform different activities how to separate substances from the mixture. Yes children, so we can separate the substances from the mixture depending upon their size, shape, color, solubility. So these are the different ways of separating the substances from the mixture.